Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel. If you have not subscribed my YouTube channel yet, do subscribe it today and press the bell icon to receive notification about my new videos. In this video, we will see how to fix Wi-Fi does not have a valid IP configuration problem in your Windows 10 operating system. So basically, when you are connected to wireless network and if the internet is not working, you will be obviously running a network adapter troubleshooter. After running the troubleshooter, sometimes it may report that Wi-Fi does not have a valid IP configuration. So how we can fix that, we will see in this video. As you can see that I am running network adapter troubleshooter and it reported the problem. Wi-Fi does not have a valid IP configuration and the issue is not fixed by the troubleshooter. This means we have to manually fix this problem at our end to get the internet working. So how to fix this problem? Let us see. First of all, right click on the start button and select command prompt admin. Click yes in the USC confirmation prompt. Now type in the first command netsh win sock and reset and press the enter key. It will reset the WinSock catalog. As you can see, it has successfully reset the WinSock catalog. Next command we have to try is the netshintip reset and press enter key. You will see this results and it will ask you to restart the computer, but we will restart altogether. First we will try this command ipconfig/release, and after executing that command, the next command we will try is ipconfig /flushdns and press enter key. And the final command we will try is that ipconfig /renew and press the enter key. Once these commands are executed successfully, we can close command prompt and restart the system. So as my system is now restarting, after rebooting and login, the problem should be automatically fixed and you should be connected to the wireless network. But if the issue is not resolved and if you are still facing the problem, you have to simply right click on the start button and select settings. Then go to network and internet. And click on the network reset link under status section, and under network reset simply click on the reset now button. Once it is done, you will have to restart your system and the problem should be fixed after that. So thanks for watching this video. Hope you found it helpful. Do like it, share it, and don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos.